नो पोजिशन ऑफ सॉलिड्स यस इन डिफरेंट पोजिशंस इंक्लाइन टू वीपी इंक्लाइन टू एचपी राइट सो हियर आल्सो नाउ वी विल बी डूइंग नाउ सेक्शंस ऑफ सॉलिड्स ओके ऑलरेडी आई गिवन द सेक्शंस ऑफ सॉलिड्स जस्ट यू ओपन दैट वन आई थिंक दैट पेज नंबर इज 38 which I posted morning day morning just open that one so before that we should know that what is the sections of solids okay now when we cut any object you have to respond amma okay when we cut any object yes when we cut any object the part inside is the same as the surface of that particular object is it like that
yes ma'am
yes when you cut the carrot it look the same texture inside like outside yes it's not no
we see circle
yes circle but what about the inside can you see the same thing now you know the kala jamun right if you cut that kala jamun what you can see inside that You see only the darkness or something other? Yes, please. Nothing. Yes, that is another material. We have to show the section part. Okay. So like unless we cut the object, we cannot justify the what is there in the material so of course that is the material is different for you so we will be learning only the sections okay so sections it will be cutting in a different positions the section plane is nothing but like a knife right the section plane is nothing but a knife I'll show you just wait Now, can you able to see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, can you able to see? Now,
yes, ma'am.
Now, AutoCAD is visible on the screen.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now here. So this is a section plane. Okay, this is a section plane. Exactly, but this is one type of a plane. Okay. So this we can. This is the imaginary plane. This is the imaginary plane. So when we look from front view, so this is the observer. So when we look the front view, this plane will be above the reference line. X Y is the reference line. See here, X Y is the reference line. This is that plane. Okay, this is a sectional plane we call. Okay, sectional plane is nothing but a knife. Okay, the position of the knife when we are cutting any object. Okay, so that is a sectional plane. So here also is another position, simple positions. So this position is the section plane is perpendicular to HP, parallel to VP, and here the section plane is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. Okay, so this is the observer. So by observing here, how can we see that this will be horizontal plane be rotated downwards, right? So this section plane is below the reference line. See this one. This will be in this way. Okay, it will be in this way. Okay, is it clear all of you? So when we cut any object, it may be in the. Let us take in this case, the section plane is perpendicular to VP and inclined to HP also. Perpendicular to VP, inclined to HP means so this portion will be something inclined. Like this also, it is possible. And in this case also, the section plane is perpendicular to HP and inclined to VP also. This is also possible. Okay, so there are this many cases the section plane. So in this way we can cut the object in this way. See here section plane. Okay, this is cutting portion. This is a section plane. Okay, and this is a regular pentagon. Regular pentagon. So this object. So this is the top view. This portion is top view. Just one. Okay, this is a sectional top view. Sectional top view means here you can see here this portion. This is the inclined edges. These are inclined edges. These are the inclined edges of this one. These are the inclined edges AO, BO, CO, DO, EO. So this is the top view. This we call here top sectional top view. Okay. So when the observer is here, when he is looking in the top view, okay, the object between the section plane, this is a section plane, is nothing but a knife, okay, like a knife. The object between the section plane and the observer, here is the observer. When we see the top view, the object is removed, assumed to be removed out. This portion is assumed to be removed out. Then only we can able to see the what is there, the sectional portion. Is it clear? Right? The object between the observer and the sectional plane, observer and the sectional plane is assumed to be removed out. This is as removed. The remaining part is this portion. The remaining part is this portion, whatever it is there. That's why I shown you here very thick lines. You can see here. This is a thick line. This is also a thick line. This is the remaining portion. This is the remaining portion. This is the front view, right? This whole thing is front view. Whereas in the top view, you can see here. So this portion is removed, right? This portion is removed from O dash to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this portion is removed. So that's why I've shown this light lines here. Okay, so once we remove this one, once we remove the top portion, this portion, once we remove, this will be a sectional plane. This will be a sectional plane. See here, this one you can see. So this one also very similar to the, what is the shape of this sectional plane? What is the shape?
Pentagonal.
So regular pentagon. Okay, regular pentagon. This one is. So is it a true shape or some inclination? Is it true shape or some inclination? It is a true shape because when the plane is parallel to either one of the plane or parallel to HP or parallel to VP, the true shape will be the section plane will be the true shape. Okay. When we cut in this way also, see here, when the plane is perpendicular to HP, and parallel to VP, see here. This is another case. So this is a true shape. This is the true shape. Okay. So here, just you write down heading. Sections of solids. Main heading is sections of solids. Sections of solids. And the side heading is, section. Have you all written? Please respond.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Side heading is section. The surface produced by cutting. The object by the section plane. Is called section. Next line. It is indicated by thin lines uniformly spread, uniformly spaced parallel and inclined at 45 degrees. And inclined at 45 degrees. Now see here, this is the section plane. Okay. Now here, this is the section plane. This is the section plane. And this is all lines are parallel, thin lines. And these all lines are 45 degrees. And equally spaced, all lines are equally spaced. So this will be here when you are drawing on the drawing sheet manually, then you have to draw the, you have to take 45 degrees and you have to draw the inclined lines 45 degrees and all should be parallel and equally spaced. Okay. But in AutoCAD is a different way. That there will be one another command like hatch. Okay. Okay, now next side heading is sectional view. Next side heading is sectional view. The projection of the section along with remaining portion of the object, along with remaining portion of the object is called sectional view or section. Sectional view. Okay. Yes? Please repeat again. I am unable to hear your voice. Hello?
Ma'am, repeat once again, ma'am. Sectional view.
The portion of the section along with remaining portion, this is the portion of the section along with remaining portion, this is the remaining portion of the object is called a sectional view. Is called a sectional view. Next line. When the projection is made on the HP, it is called sectional top view. This is sectional top view. Okay, this whole thing is sectional top view. And that on VP is called sectional front view. It's called sectional front view. Okay. Now next side heading is section planes. Section planes, PLANES, section planes. The section planes cutting plane or imaginary plane are assumed to be thin, transparent, perpendicular to the reference planes means these are the reference planes, vertical plane and the horizontal plane. These are the reference planes. And either or inclined or inclined to the other. Means now these two are parallel to HP, perpendicular to VP, and this is perpendicular to HP, parallel to VP. And it is possible the section plane is perpendicular to VP and inclined to HP also, like you have done in the projection of surfaces, projection of planes. Okay, so there are the many cases. Now next line. Types of section planes. Types of section planes. First one is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. Section plane is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. Second one is perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. Parallel to HP. So this is second one. This is the first one. This is second one. And next one, perpendicular to VP and inclined to HP. Perpendicular to VP, inclined to HP. So this is the perpendicular to VP and inclined. If you move like this, if this portion if you move like this, so it will be inclined to HP. Perpendicular to VP and inclined to HP. Fourth one is perpendicular to HP and inclined to VP. Perpendicular to HP and inclined to VP. And fifth one is perpendicular to both HP and VP. Perpendicular to both HP and VP means it will be in this way. Suppose this is a section, I will draw on this. Like this. This is one. This is perpendicular to both HP and VP. Is it clear now? Okay. So these all cases, these five cases, we have to do on prisms, pyramid, cone, and cylinders. Okay. Prisms, pyramid, cone, and cylinders. If possible, on spheres also. Okay. Now, next line. True shape of the section. Next side heading is true shape of the section. Are you all writing or not?
Yes, ma'am.
True shape of the section. Yes, roll number 117.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you writing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So please write down, please maintain the notes. Sometimes that will be the assignment marks. Okay, roll number 119. Roll number 119. Roll number 70.
Yes,
ma'am. Okay, roll number 69.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, now next side reading is true shape of the section. Next side reading is true shape of the section. The true form of the cut surface. The true form of the cut surface is called. The true form of the cut surface is called. It's called true shape of the section. The true form of the cut surface is called true shape of the section. It is obtained by viewing the object. It is obtained by viewing the object normal to the cut surface I am projecting it on a plane parallel to the section plane. Next side reading, section lines. The true shape of true shape means what? Now here you can see this is the, now here the section plane is perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP in this case, right? Now true shape will be seen in the top view. Right? When you see from top view, the here you can see in the top view. Okay, whereas in this case The section plane is perpendicular to HP, parallel to VP. Okay, this is a section here. You can see this is a section perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. Okay, now like this. This case. So when you see from top view, the section plane will be looking like a line. So here in the top view. Top view means it will come in below the reference line. It will come below the reference line. So the section section is here from 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is a true shape. This is a true shape. Okay. This is a true shape. So this is that. And if the section plane is inclined, suppose the section plane is inclined. Okay. So how it will be seen? The true shape will be seen when the view is perpendicular to that section plane. The view is, now suppose if you cut the carrot, suppose if you take an example of carrot, okay, if you cut the section plane, just you keep a carrot in front of you, take a knife and cut some inclination. Okay, suppose let us say the inclination is inclined to HP, perpendicular to VP. Okay, then what happens when you see, how can you see when you see in the from top view, it will be seen as a ellipse or a circle. Yes, please respond. Hello,
ma'am. Didn't get you, ma'am.
Listen again. When you cut a carrot, some inclination, not perpendicular to either one of planes, not
ellipse.
Now, what I'm asking is, if you see the from top view, is it ellipse or circle?
Circle.
Yeah, circle, ma'am.
Circle. So when you can see the ellipse
from side view.
Side view. Side view means you are trying to look that portion, the true shape, exactly a plane of that knife, right? Perpendicular to that. Now you can see there, just turn the page of 40, you can see the cylinder, right?